Yeah. so much. Thank you all for coming down here and joining us tonight. I know that with Sandy coming here and trying to hold the people of New York down, most other states probably would have said, we're going to stay home, but not New York. So thank you for coming here tonight. Thank you for letting us help you keep your mind on some of that stuff, just for 9 years. We really appreciate it. 20 years ago, we did a record called Countdown to Extinction. We're actually celebrating that record right now. We've been going around the world and playing it, and without any further ado, we're going to play Countdown to Extinction. This song is called Skin in Your Teeth. Thank you. you. Are you feeling good? Thank you. This next song, actually, this is a song that Dave Ellison helped write the lyrics for. This is a song about farming, and in Reaganomics back in 1992, the president had loaned all the farmers a bunch of money, and then he decided to take it back, and he destroyed the farmers in the United States. And this song, Dave felt compelled to write because his dad was a farmer. This song is called Foreclosure of a Dream.
Thank you.
Baseless destruct my story. Thank you. Thank you. Man, I was so looking forward to playing with you tonight. Not that I don't love New Jersey, because New Jersey's been a great friend to Megadeth too, but when we heard that we were moving the date to New York City, it's really cool for us, because we've had such a long relationship with the New Jersey, New York area. The funny thing is, a lot of people around the world think that metal came from Los Angeles, where me and my old band came from, but there is so much metal that came from this area out here. This next song, believe it or not, a lot of people think that guys like us, that we like to sacrifice animals and stuff like that. I like to eat them, but I don't like to sacrifice them. Actually, this next song, we won an award for this song from, of all people, Doris Day. You probably don't know who that old bat is, but I'm sure your parents do. This song is called Countdown to Extinction.
Species came to face,
Thank you. You still with me? Thank you, thank you. You know, it's funny, when Katrina hit down in New Orleans, everyone watched what a pathetic job FEMA did. And now, sadly, you guys are experiencing FEMA. Coast. How many of you have been affected by the storm? A lot of you, right? I was reading the newspaper the other day and I saw a picture of the volunteers, all you beautiful people, the volunteers that are helping all your neighbors. Feeding the FEMA people. Those lazy bastards are supposed to be feeding you. See, one of the good things about me not being president is I would put them all in jail for a very long time. The key to why FEMA sucks is the first letter F for federal. This next song is called Captive Army. Thank you.
Yo! Yo! Guy in the middle of the stairway! Yo!
Yeah.
you all tonight. Check this out. I was online looking at my friend Alex Jones' website and I saw this story in Pennsylvania, the Pennsylvania inter-school, I think it was the hockey league, said that they don't want to play the national anthem at their hockey games anymore because it costs too much money. They figured it out. It costs $7 for them to use the ice for the minute and 30 seconds to play the national anthem. $7, and that's too much money for them to play our national anthem.
Fuck that shit!
Fuck that!
The guy's name is Sam. His last name is S-A-M. Look it up. Send him an email and tell him what a piece of shit he is for trying to check out our national anthem. Okay, I wish I played hockey so I could bash his people with the stick. Then I would probably get stuck in a penalty box or something like that. Obviously, freedom and liberty means nothing to him. This next song is about freedom and liberty. This song is called Holy Rose.